Gold Digger Sound is a first of its kind on the level that we're doing it, with 11 boutique hotel rooms paired with 9 recording studios at the same facility. We also have a club here. The property has 2 buildings, a front building with the club and the hotel, and a Bow Truss building in the back, which at one point was Ed Wood's soundstage. Some of the fun facts, Plan 9 from Outer Space was filmed here. There's a really cool trap door out on the soundstage where Bela Lugosi would come out of the coffin, or they would do like ground shot fog coming over the cemetery type shots. And we actually cut the floor so we can get down there still. And we've been talking about making an echo chamber down in the Bela Lugosi grave. It became a very famous rehearsal studio called Shamrock. Legend has it, some of the last Doors rehearsals, Hendrix rehearsals here in Los Angeles. Slayer had a rehearsal room for a bit, just right on the other side of this window. And there's a Slayer graffiti that we're keeping on the wall. And just trying to preserve the history of the building. I know when we first came in, there were a bunch of local people on the block, you know, afraid we were coming in like crazy developers gonna knock down a bunch of history, which is the farthest from the truth. We came in knowing the history and wanting to preserve the creative aspect of the campus. What's really important when you're building a studio, the safest bet is going with what I call the greatest hits. Greatest hits are Neve, API, UA, pool tech style EQs, modern classics like the Distressors, gear that every producer, every engineer is familiar with and will just gravitate towards. API is one of the biggest greatest hits, and it's one of the reasons we wanted to focus on offering a classic Los Angeles style recording console. The way we see Gold Digger Sound fitting in with the international scene is producers, writers, artists coming from around the world, leaving the comfort of their own home studios, but coming to Los Angeles and being able to walk right into a studio that feels very much like a well-equipped home studio. So it's important to us that we get a bunch of the right synths, drum machines, instruments, amps. That's something else that we're paying close attention to, keep up with the needs of writers, producers, and the tools they need other than the Pro Audio. We worked very close with a local designer named Tiffany Howell, and she's helped bring a very home yet modern feel to the hotel and the studios and all parts of the campus, including she completely redid the club as well. It was just important to us that it wasn't too sterile or too overdone one way or the other. We just wanted it to have a, like, this is my apartment, this is my house type feel. One great thing about the whole campus we have here is at any given time you're going to have writers, producers, artists staying up in the hotel, possibly recording in the studio, possibly playing shows in town, but they're all going to congregate in the club. And the club, it's like a Bukowski style strip club bar here on East Hollywood. It was really important that we didn't change that, at least the aura of it. So we kept the sign, kept the name. You know, a lot of different names were flying around, and eventually we're just like, it's called Gold Diggers. We're keeping it Gold Diggers. LA is such a hub for music and entertainment in general. Let's say you're coming here for a month to do various co-writing sessions, or you're working on a project. You know you're going to be here for 3 weeks, 3 months. We can offer a room and a hotel, so you literally have a home base here while you're working in Los Angeles. Our studios range from anywhere from a small audio office on up to Studio One with a full sound stage and anything in between. That's something I don't think is available out there. I know there's a lot of destination studios. There's a few hotels that offer rooms, but not on the level that we're doing it and the options that we're